Hi, I'm John Bonebrake from the University of Buffalo School of Engineering and Applied Sciences office. This video addresses the resign process. Email your assigned academic advisor if you have follow-up questions. You can find your advisor in the Hub Student Center. Please note that websites mentioned are easily found by a Google search. They are also listed below in the description section on YouTube. First off, the resign deadline for the spring semester has been pushed back until the last day of final exams, May 16th, due to the shift to online instruction because of the COVID-19 pandemic, meaning you have more time to determine whether resign is in your best interest or not for this semester. If you receive financial aid before resigning anything, please contact the financial aid office at ubfa@buffalo.edu or call 716-645-8232 with specific questions first. There are many financial aid scenarios, and they are unique to each student. It is important to reach out to financial aid in a timely manner as your office does get busy. If you are an international student, you must communicate with the ISS office before resigning if you will fall below full-time status. Being registered in fewer than 12 credits impacts your visa status. Several other things to consider before resigning a course: impact on transcript, limited enrollment rules, progress towards admission to major degree, summer versus winter registration, SU grading option, some other considerations. So first, impact on transcript. A resign is indicated on your transcript with an R and does not factor into your GPA. An R indicator is not a negative mark. If this is not your first resign, however, consider talking with your advisor about it. There could be some negative connotations with several resigns in certain graduate programs, for example. Some classes are limited enrollment classes as listed on the Repeat Policy website. Typically, this means you'd want to consider retaking these classes over winter or summer. However, for this semester only, due to the sudden changes with every class being online due to the coronavirus, UB is relaxing the controlled enrollment course policy. They are not lifting the restrictions, however, until the early summer. Progress towards admission to major degree. Look at your major's flow sheet to see how much the courses you're considering resigning impacts your timeline with the major. For example, let's say you're mechanical engineering. Resigning Math 142 this semester impacts your ability to enroll in ES 207 the following semester, which then impacts dynamics and solids, and so on. Intended engineering and computer science students planning to resign a core course need to understand the admissions criteria. Repeating a core class that you resigned does not count as one of the two maximum repeats allowed. Refresh your memory on your major's admissions criteria. Summer versus winter registration. If you are considering taking a course you are resigning over the summer, University of Buffalo summer enrollment is already open, meaning you could register now already into a summer class. Go to ubthissummer.buffalo.edu and click on the department and see the listings to see if the class is available. If you are considering taking a course you resigned over the summer at a different school, you can check taurus.buffalo.edu to see if a school local to you has equivalency to that class. Okay, very importantly now, SU grading policy. Also unique to the spring 2020 semester due to the shift to online instruction, you can now select the satisfactory, unsatisfactory grading option. Grades A through C grants an S. C minus through F grants a U. An S grade will earn you credit but will not impact GPA. So regardless if you got an A or a C, it still indicates an S. A U grade will not earn credit but will also not impact your GPA, meaning if you got an F in the class, you would receive a U and that will not impact your GPA. Bear in mind, a U grade does not satisfy a degree requirement, but earning an S does. You can always opt for SU grading now, and if you end up getting a really good grade in the class, you can still elect to recover the actual grade after the semester is finished. Likewise with a U, if you receive a U and would like to receive the C minus or whatever grade that might still be passing, you can do that. If you'd like to go ahead and elect for SU grading, there is a form you can complete, and the deadline to do that is the last day of final exams on May 16th. If you're not a School of Engineering and Applied Sciences major, please consult with your own department on how SU grading impacts your major. There are financial aid considerations with SU grading if you receive a U. You might have specific questions for an academic advisor regarding your intended, admitted, or conditional major status in regards to SU grading. The SU grading option is a great opportunity for students this semester. Please consult the website mentioned here. Also listen to the YouTube description to find more information on this and other relevant Spring 2020 semester updates for CS students, including recorded webinars on SU grading and other important topics. Other considerations. There are certainly other questions you might have, for example, regarding health insurance, car insurance, having veteran status, etc. Please contact the appropriate office for any of these scenarios. And again, you can always check in with your academic advisor. Now on to the how-to. To resign a class, navigate to the Hub Student Center. It's the same process as dropping a class. You can find a tutorial by visiting the registrar website listed below. If you're unsure about any of this, please contact your academic advisor via email or think about scheduling a phone or WebEx appointment. You can set up an appointment with your academic advisor by following the directions found in this link. Okay, thanks for watching.